Quiz platforms have been becoming increasingly popular in the language classroom over the last decade. They are a unique and interactive tool, capable of engaging our students in a different way to a traditional coursebook. And none is as popular as Kahoot. Kahoot allows teachers to create quizzes to support the content they're covering in class, which can then be played by pupils either in class or at home. They're adaptable, having a variety of question types, a variety of modes in which your pupils play, and they can be used for a variety of purposes in your classroom. However, I, like many other teachers, can often struggle to find the time to make the quizzes that complement my coursebook material. And I sometimes wonder, wouldn't it be nice if a book came with Kahoots already made? Well, I've got some good news for you. Both the THiNK and the American THiNK series from Cambridge University Press now have a corresponding Kahoot quiz which covers the core vocabulary and grammar of that unit. There are 11 questions per unit. Two for the two core vocabulary sets, two for the two grammar points, two vocabulary questions for the fluency phrases, culture or literature lessons, and a final open-ended question related to the unit topic. For the purposes of this video, I'll be using examples from THiNK. So let's have a look in detail at how these THiNK Kahoot quizzes can help you as a teacher, whether you're in a physical, online, or blended learning setting. First, they can be used at various points throughout your lesson. This could be during some of the smaller stages, such as leading into your class, recapping on previous lessons' content, as an energizer between individual heads down activities, or as homework. Or you could use them during some of the bigger stages of your class. In the presentation stage, you could use them as extra examples or to present material related to today's lesson. Or you can use them at the practice stage of your class, maybe to check understanding before starting the stage, or you can leave the answers on the board to provide support during the controlled and free practice. Assessment of your pupils is also made easier with the THiNK Kahoots. It can be used as a diagnostic tool to identify gaps in your students' knowledge and then guide the next steps in learning. Or you can use them at the end of a lesson or a course to see how much content has been understood by your students. Kahoot also serves as a directory to monitor your students' progress over time. You can track their scores, allowing you to either give support or push pupils further where necessary. One particular assessment function that I love using in my class is the ghost function. Using player data from a past game, Kahoot can generate ghosts your pupils can compete against. The differentiation needs of your class can also be helped by THiNK Kahoot. If the player versus player or team versus team modes get too competitive or too personal, get your pupils to compete against virtual players. They can also serve as an activity for fast finishers in your class, and individual students can also be assigned particular quizzes to help meet their personal learning needs. Your ability to give good feedback is also helped by THiNK Kahoots. The immediate and clear presentation of results allows you to give the right feedback, whether during or after a quiz. And a feedback tool that I personally love are the polls. You can set up polls to stimulate interest in a topic or find out your pupils' opinions of a topic. So let's recap on how THiNK Kahoot quizzes can help you as a teacher. Don't forget, there is a version for American THiNK as well as THiNK, and you can find out more about them both here. Whatever version you choose to use, or however you choose to use them, enjoy using THiNK Kahoots in your classroom.